Dear friends, today I will deal on the subject. We all are human beings. We get occasionally anger. But if it is a regular process, it is something different with mind. People who are very much angry with the other people, they are not sound at their mind. Angry, we should avoid. Many people try to avoid, but it is not a possible thing for all the people. To control anger, we have to go for meditation. Meditation is the best source to control angry. But still people get angry unnecessarily, unnoticingly. They never think that they are getting anger. So they go on crying on other people, making big complaints and showing angry by pounding their heart. That is the situation in many cases. We can see from our Puranas also that Vishwamitra, due to angry, he has downfallen from his Brahmarshi position again to Rajarshi position. That is, his anger has made him like that. His penance, it was collapsed because of Menaka. So naturally people's thinking and they what they their ego, they will become abundantly, it rises from time to time, and the people will become ignorant that they are getting angry. Angry is the situation everybody will fall into its prey. But those who knows that they are getting cold, angry, they will try to control it. If we are not able to control our angry within half an hour or so, at least within 30 minutes, if we are not able to control our anger, it is something different to be taken care by very wonderful homeopathic medicine. You might have heard some more stories from our mythology. One Kaushika. Kaushika was a saint. He was doing a penance under a tree. A crane has dropped its fetal material on his head, and he used his power of his penance, and the crane has dead, spot dead, it burnt. So like that he has lost his all power of doing prayers to God. Likewise, Bhrigu Maharshi went to the heaven. There he cursed Lord Shiva, he cursed Lord Brahma, and he beat on the chest of Lord Vishnumurti. This is all because of anger. Anger is a part of our life through ages. Since you so many eras, we are getting this kind of anger. Because why we get anger is, we feel that we are doing everything is right. That is the main reason. So we have to control our anger. A good homeopathy approach to dealing with anger is important. Homeopathy can do wonders in controlling anger. Anger related many subjects are there. Anger is related with depression, anxiety, worry, and many other things. Let us study some of the points. Now I will start. It is important for us all that we learn to control what can be a negative emotion and have a huge consequences to our own emotional and physical health because of anger. physical health and emotional health are affected, and also the well-being and lives of those around us. We are not worried. Our surrounding people are also worried if we are angry. Normally, no harm is done with little anger. Hurt feelings, bruised pride, increases ego, and a sense of being temporarily out of control, which is often hopefully balanced by heartfelt apology and possibly lessons learnt. Generally, people, when they realize, they go to the people and say, "Pardon me, excuse me," like that they will use the words, and they will say sorry. But if still you are not doing that and having ego and anger with you, you need a treatment. It does, however, risk becoming pathological and a danger to one's health when it cannot be controlled or channeled positively and in a short period of time. The people cannot control their anger in a short period of time. This can cause both physical and mental problems, which can become deep-seated in brain. That is important. High blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, and a variety of emotional health problems. Symptoms would depend on the cause, but could include violence, rudeness. Some people, unknowingly, they throw everything in the house. They break the TV, they break other good utensils, or any other thing, any glass material, like that the people will do because of this kind of angry. Symptoms would depend on the cause, but could include violence, rudeness, loss of control, and inability to be rational. Physically, flushed face will be an indication showing the anger. Increased blood pressure, tension throughout the body, rapid pulse, shortness of breath, and shaking. When somebody is in angry, their body will shake. Generally, they will lose stability. As a consequence, the immune system can become affected as the vital force is knocked off balance. There are few things worse than absorbing the vibration of someone who is permanently angry with life. We can see the people always in angry mood, always in angry mood. These are few things worse than absorbing the vibration of someone who is permanently angry with life. For both the victims and his or her victims, it is essential to focus and address the root cause of the problem and treat with an appropriate remedy. Here I am talking about angry because homeopathy will help to bring the body into a state of balancing the mind and the body by addressing specific causes. Anger is frequently caused by overwhelming stress and anxiety, but the specific state would be addressed and a suitable remedy suggested in keeping with the totality of the characteristic symptoms. Underneath the anger could lie feelings of fear, anxiety, hurt, humiliation, feelings of rejection, physical or emotional abuse, or it could be a physical problem affecting the mind, all of which could be discovered throughout in-depth consultation. If the homeopathy doctor asks, they can get out so many things from the patient. Along with anger, there are many other side effects. There may be a cause of love failure or suspicion or any other illusion, any depression, any anxiety. All these things will cause uncontrolled anger. Now we will go to remedies to consider. first and foremost is arnica. Arnica 200. Take arnica 200 potency once in a week. Those who are continuously in anger, and if the anger follows a fright, they will fear. If fright follows anger, then you should think of arnica. Number two medicine, aurum metallicum. In this people, deep depression, fear, worry accompanying the anger, very sensitive, possibly talks of suicide. This is the symptoms of aurum metallicum. All these medicines, whatever I am going to tell, take in 200 potency once in a week for chronic cases. Generally, all the angry cases are chronic. They are with us for years together. So we should think that we are giving them in 200 potency weekly one dose. One dose means if you are purchasing liquid, take 5 drops on the tongue, or if you have purchased pills, take 5 pills on the tongue. Number 3 medicine, Bryonia alba. If everything is irritating and the anger is accompanied by a headache, parched mouth and dizziness, these are the symptoms which require Bryonia. Chamomilla. Chamomilla is very much suitable for the children. The children get very much angry and annoyed. They throw away everything in their hands. They break the things. They don't hear the mother. They don't hear the father. They don't hear the elders. They will throw away everything around them like that, because they may have some colic and they may have some sweating. Or teething babies, they also get angry. They cry. They cry always. And temper in children, people of all ages. Pain for both the victim and the witness is often intolerable. Here, the mother and the child both will suffer because of the anger of the child. That is important. Number 3 is Sina, C-I-N-A, Sina. Sina 200. This medicine, in this condition, anger accompanied by nervousness. Nervousness means shaky hands, shaky muscles, like that. Children can be particularly abusive. The elders will always scold the children. Unnecessarily, they scold the children. They will ask them to sit straight, to drink properly, to eat properly. So many things they will go on teaching the children. They will become very abusive. Then they will start getting angry. Frequently, then in that children, intestinal worms are the part of the picture. And again, colocynthis. This is anger with indigestion, often accompanied by stomach cramps. Always there will be pain in the stomach. And ignatia. This is also a wonderful medicine where anger follows grief. Grief means some tragedy in the family, some kind of tragedy. Some old woman died, some young children died, like that, some kind of grief in the family. It creates anger in some people. They will, it follows grief, shock or disappointment. If a girl or a boy expects a seat in medical college or an engineering college, if he failed in getting a seat, then he will get disappointment and always gets some unhopeful things and melancholic. He wants to be alone. And next medicine, Mercusol. In this people, sudden anger with an impulse to do violence. They want to beat the people. In the anger, what they do, they don't believe. They never think that what they are doing. Sometimes they injure the opposite people. Natrum Moor, next medicine, Natrum Moor. It is needed for the children or adults, ill effects from anger with fear. With fear, somebody gets anger. Then they need Natrum Moor, sometimes vengeful. they are vengeful and violent. Nitric acid, next medicine is nitric acid. Hateful, vindictive, headstrong, but with hopeless despair. They say all negative things. They lose everything. They don't have confidence. Sensitive to noise, pain and touch. For them, nitric acid is a good remedy. Nux vomica, this is a common remedy. Violent temper and cannot bear contradiction. They don't want to discuss anything with the opposite people. They say what they want, they say that is final. They don't want to discuss the things. They will never involve in contradiction. What they want, they think that it is final. Generally irritable and very much angry. Anger may lead to indigestion. Person is irritable and cannot bear noise or smells. Moody and fault-finding and with a fiery temperament. All these things are there in Nux Vomica. And sepia, this is a medicine name, sepia. Sepia is good remedy for premenstrual or menopause anger. Generally, women get angry before menstrual periods. Likewise, if they are reaching menopause stage at 48, 45, 46, up to 50, they will get very much anger. They are angry with each and everybody. They scold husband, they scold the children, like that, because of the menstrual premenstrual period or menopause period, they get very, very irritated and they get angry. This thing can be settled with sepia. They are very sad and weepy with anxiety towards evening. Morning they will bear the things, by evening even their anxiety is increased and they will weep loudly. That is the case of a sepia. And finally, Staphysagria is a medicine for the children who are doing, children means youth, teens. They will involve in many effects of environment. They attain the puberty age, so they think say many things which they cannot keep in their mind. They want to see obscene scenes. They go to smartphone. They see many unnecessary scenes in the phone, and the TV effect is there on them, and they get angry and they get insults. If somebody insult them, they will get angry. Suppressed anger. Because of younger children, the adults will get angry on them, so they cannot rebound on them. So they suppress their anger. A common remedy for suppressed anger that is suddenly explosive. For that people, Staphysagria. Above all these things, we can give sulfur. Sulfur, it feels depressed, weak, lazy and irritable, selfish, with no regard for others. These are the symptoms who require sulfur. Feels depressed, weak, lazy and irritable, selfish, with no regard to elders or others. In addition to consulting a homeopathy, there is much you can do for yourself. Identify the cause and any situations that are likely to provoke anger. Avoid where possible and realize the negative, destructive effect exposing yourself to these situations has on you and others. Exercise helps to work out negative energies, and does yoga and meditation. Cultivate your loves and interests and focus on what you enjoy and what gives you profound satisfaction. Music, writing, painting, etc. Avoid any sort of addictive behavior. Don't addict to alcohol, drugs or fast food, or at least recognize it and seek help. This behavior can cause or exacerbate the state. Try and be positive and nurture loving thoughts. Be accountable for your actions and reasons with yourself. Imagine you are a highly esteemed role model for your family, friends and children, and act like you would like them to do so. You love the children, that's all. That is a good habit. You like the trees around you. You like the plants you have planted and enjoy the nature. Likewise, you can control your anger. By controlling your anger, you will be healthier and happier and will be able to radiate your calm to a positive effect on those around you. The change starts with you. Remember this point. The change starts with you. For more advice, I request you to contact a good homeopathy doctor available to you. With this, I say goodbye to you. Please understand, hear this once or twice, and this will help you a lot to control your anger, to be perfect in your life. Love the people, love the nature, love around the people around you. Help the beggars, help the people, who poor people. Do lot of things that can control your anger. Don't be selfish. Give something to the needy, and you are loving the nature means you are controlling your anger. Anger is the first enemy for us. Try to control it. Thank you very much.